everything on the universe on how our planet circles around our sun. Well, I think both the flat Earth and the round Earth circle around our flat sun and round sun. Oh, I know. And there's just no way they can answer the questions. Go ahead. I'm a flat Earther. Ask me a question. I'll give you an answer.
Explain this.
That is. All right, I have the perfect answer for you. Well, you know, when you were a kid, there was, you were that giant with a magnifying glass in your hand, and you used to heat up anteaters and burn little ants?
No, I would never do that.
Oh, no, you wouldn't do it, but there's other people that would. Well, actually, as humans, We're nothing more than an anthill, and somebody's looking, a larger being is looking at us through a magnifying glass, and when they do, it gets warmer. And, you know, they only do this about once a year, but that's where the heat's coming from, is that magnifying glass. Oh, no, not me. God. Oh, I did, didn't I? Well, I guess I'm not a very good flat earther. Well, you have to ask yourself one question before you ask that question. How does diarrhea work on the flat Earth? Yeah, it can get pretty crappy. Yeah. Yeah, the technology that we take for granted, and there's still people around that don't believe it. In fact, there's people, of course you know that too, that still think going to the moon was nothing but a hoax.
Yeah, it was the most elaborate hoax of all time. They did things that conceived of some of the things that they would have.
You're probably right for that one.
Not that it was easy to do, but there's a the other day, I don't remember what radio show I was listening to, but a typical cell phone that's around now is 100,000 times more powerful than the Apollo computer was.
Yeah, I heard that too. And that's probably true.
I'll bet the cell phone is more than 100,000 times more powerful than
they still use vacuum tubes.
No, actually they didn't have vacuum tubes. I remember it from the computers quite a bit, but they did use core memory. The unwound memory cores made little tiny beads, direct beads. That's how the memory was built.
So it made, the memory was one bit, one core was one bit in a word.
One core was one bit, yeah.
Wow.
But they actually had two computers, one of them in the command module and the other in the motor module.
Yeah, it's amazing.
What's amazing is that they actually made all that stuff work and programmed it, and I mean, it astounds me how much they accomplished in a few years with all that coming together and how much stuff they invented and tested. I mean, maybe they couldn't simulate any of that on a computer model. They could go and do it to see what would work and what wouldn't. And doing all that in that amount of time, that was very ambitious.
Oh, yeah. And just think, we have the United States Space Force now, and we're headed back to the moon. This time I think we can do it. Well, Donald wants to be there by 2024, doesn't he?
I think it's more time to look at 2024. I did hear him talking about that a couple of years ago. Yeah, it's probably been 5 years.
Well, I think they can do it. I believe they can. I don't see any reason why they can't. And there's some remarkable people. And they're just waiting. This is their whole life. They've been waiting for this project or to be involved with something like this. It's just like the people who wanted to be involved in nuclear projects or even... I told you about Jack Shedd, and he was involved with the nuclear spaceship that never got off the ground because after they realized it wouldn't work, they just kept going. But he was a part of that. You know, it was the excitement of science. Science is so cool. Technology is so cool. And we're not going to get to live to see much more of it. Well, you're 60. I doubt very much you're going to live to be 100.
Oh, yeah, the breakthroughs that I have in the next couple of decades, they'll be able to nurse me along to 120 easy.
Maybe. WAQLS.
W8AM. The Apollo computer, the words were 16-bit, had 24 kilowords originally, and they increased it to 36, so 36 kilobytes, basically, while the device would have been 16-bit. So, 64 kilobytes of memory.
Boy, you waste that much just by, well, you waste gigabytes just by turning your computer on.
Yeah, nowadays, a kilobyte, I mean, you can't do anything with a kilobyte in a Windows computer.
No.
Just the logo is probably 10 times that.
Yeah.
That's one of the reasons I like fooling around with the propeller and, you know, the Arduino, because you get down to the nitty-gritty and actually can program the microprocessor to do things. You don't have that incredibly huge overhead that the operating systems have.
Yeah, I'll tell you, human life is way too short. There's just so many things, so much to get interested in, and so much that you can get excited about, and you only can do one little thing in your life if you're going to do it well, because there isn't, but, you know, very little time in our lifetime.
You got to figure out what you like to do and do that well, because you certainly can't do it all.
How long does a robin live, or a sparrow? Do you have any idea?
I do not.
A robin lives, I think, a year and a half, maybe up to 2 years, but they die relatively quickly. Sparrow can live up to 3 years. Birds really live a very short period of time. they don't nest in the same place. A lot of people believe they come back every year to their birthplace and build another nest around, but that isn't true. I watch birds all the time. I really don't know that much about them, but I watch birds all the time, and I just love the birds that we have around here. We have all sorts of birds that you really, really wouldn't believe you have until you stop and pay attention, but they don't live very long.
Well, some birds do live a long time. I know, like, parrots and cockatoos and other things, they can live 50 years.
Oh, yeah, some live longer than that. Some live 150 years. I think the blue and gold, the call, a short lifespan would be 75 year.
Yeah. Some people get one as a pet thinking, oh, you know, I live for 5 or 10 years, and then they realize those birds are going to outlive you.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, it's a lifetime project to have one. I had a, well, I suspect it's still alive. I had an African gray that I bought back. It wasn't very old. It was only about a year old when I got it. I bought back in 1970. He was expected to live 100 years. And here it is. I'm getting ready to expire, and that bird's still going strong.
Wonder how long hummingbirds live.
I don't know. That's what Tika asked me to look up. In fact, I'll do it right now. But because their metabolism is so high, and I think they have to eat 1 or 2 times their weight every day. Now, we feed them, and she's been watching them come out on the front porch. We have a feeder out there for them. And it's only been up for a day, and already we have a bunch of hummingbirds. But let me look up and see how long the hummingbird in this area lives. Give me a minute. WAQLS.
WAN. Yeah, I looked up real quick. 3 to 5 years is what I see. And we do the same thing. I've kept hummingbird feeders out for years because they're very interesting to watch. We've got two of them. We got one right outside the front window, and we got one over there. I fill those things up a couple times a week. It's fun to watch them because they're very territorial. When one of them sit there, you don't want to let another one in there. They'll chase each other around. It's really cool to watch.
Oh, yeah, yeah. There's, I watch the robins every day, and we even named them. You can tell them apart after a while. We've got about 15. One was just eaten the other day by a hawk. I don't know what pair that was eaten out of because they're, you know, they're always pairs. When I drive today, when I cut the grass, and the same thing happens all the time, we've got these swallows around here that dive. You think they're dive bombing you, but they're not. You pick up the bugs or the flying insects when you're cutting the grass, and they're flying by eating the insects out of the air that you kick up all the time. And that's pretty cool to watch. And, I don't know. Birds are just cool. We've got red birds, the cardinals. We have bluebirds. We have woodpeckers. Just all sorts of cool birds.
Yeah, we have a finch feeder, too, the kind that the finch hangs upside down and eat. It's really funny to watch the sparrows try to get in there because there's no way that they can do it. They'll climb on there and try to reach, you know, down underneath, and then they fall off and fly around. It's just incredibly funny. And our finch feeder is right next to the hummingbird feeder, so sometimes the hummingbirds, there'll be a finch on the finch feeder, and the hummingbird sees it, and he wants to try to scare him away, and he starts buzzing around him, but the finch doesn't care, and the hummingbird, you know, freaking out, and it's really cool to watch him.
Oh, yeah, WAQLF at 20F.
W-8-A-F.
Yeah, it's really interesting to watch birds, and I'm not really sure when I started watching birds. It's been over the past probably 10 years, 15 years. I know when we lived over in South Toledo, I was buying 200 pounds of seed every week. I used to go to Anderson's, and we'd put the seat down, and the neighbors would, I'm sure they hated me because the birds never sat at our house. They sat all around, and we would have 1,500, 2,000 sparrows waiting for the food every day, and we put the food out, and birds are cramping on everybody else's property while they're staying away from ours while they're, you know, waiting for me to put out the seat.
Wow, I'm seeing a hummingbird's heart rate is more than 1,200 beats per minute, and the respiration is average 250 breaths per minute.
Oh my gosh, how much do they have to eat every day?
Well, this thing says a hummingbird must consume approximately half its weight in sugar daily.
Half its weight in sugar. That's a lot of calories. You figure they're less than, well, they're less than an ounce.
They feed 5 to 8 times per hour.
Yeah, yeah. That's as much as what I used to have sex.
And they fly more than 3,000 miles when they migrate.
Oh, now that's something I did. Wow, 3,000 miles of migration.
Well, that's the ones that live up in Canada and Alaska. Probably the ones here don't have to go that far, but still, I know they like to go down to Mexico in the wintertime, and that's still quite a haul, considering their wings are beating 50 to 200 flaps per second.
And how fast do they fly?
30 miles an hour average and a dive.
Oh, okay. Well, the hawks are here year-round.
Well, it says they fly 500 miles non-stop across the Gulf of Mexico. Can you imagine that
they'd have to charge up before they go, because that's a long way to go without any food if they gotta eat.
Well, you know, if their average is 5 to 8 times an hour, they're used to eating half their weight in sugar, and now all of a sudden they're going 500 miles nonstop with no food.
Yeah, and think that they, yes, they ran into a storm.
Yeah, I wonder how many of them end up in the Gulf.
Probably quite a few.
Yeah, this is the average lifespan of a wild hummingbird is 3 to 12 years.
Whoa. Well, do you remember when we're flying along in a Cherokee and we would get bugs on the windshield at 10,000 feet? Do you ever remember seeing that?
Oh, yeah.
And you wonder, geez, how can these bugs get up here, 10,000 feet? Those birds must use thermals to fly, too. I mean, they're not very heavy, and if they catch a thermal, the thermal lifts them at a high, you know, a rate of speed and gets them up there and thousands of feet. All they have to do is hold their wings out and fly back down and catch another thermal and go back up and then fly down. Of course, downward gravity pulls them down and forward at the same time. So I'm sure they don't have to beat their wings all the way. They're still going to use the forces of nature.
This article says that they are one of the most aggressive bird species. You know, we realize they were up at the top. Most aggressive birds.
Wow, do they attack the hawks and eagles?
They attack jays, crows, hawks.
Wow. Well, they're quick. I mean, you know, I don't think there's any birds faster than they are. as far as agility.
Well, yeah, it's the only bird that can fly backwards.
Yep.